Today we're looking at metal-clad switches and sockets from Hamilton. So metal-clad, Gary, what's the first thing that comes into your head?
Knocking one out, Gordon.
Okay, you mean removing the knockout?
Knocking one out, Gordon, absolutely, yeah. We take the cover off and we're faced with all those punch-through holes. How easy is it going to be? Well, here we go. So, screwdriver and hammer, one firm strike on top of the screwdriver. It's popped through, gentle wiggle, and I've released it from its enclosure.
Ah, okay, that's good. And we look at a lot of metal clad accessories, and it's a fine line between some that end up looking like a kettle drum and need a spot of panel beating when you're trying to remove the knockout, and others where it just almost accidentally falls out, which you wouldn't want happening on your final installation.
Absolutely, and subtle little things like that we're gonna see throughout the Hamilton range, and they've got a lot in the range, so it's all in front of us here, Gordon. There is a lot of stuff to look at, isn't there?
Yeah, I mean, it's everything you'd expect. Double sockets, we've got some USB sockets, we've got some fused spurs, but we've got some grid switches we're gonna look at, and even our old friend, the Euro module. But there's one that really stood out to you, Gary. Which one's that?
The red one. Okay, yeah. So what's the thinking behind the red one, Gordon?
Okay, well, it's eFIXX red. I'll possibly try to mimic a 1980s Argos-inspired teenager's bedroom. Okay, the label gives it away.
Okay, let's have a look at that label then, Gordon.
So, do not switch off, burglar alarm, nurse call panel, or fire alarm.
Okay, nurse call panel, you got one in your place?
I think you'll need it before me.
Okay.
But obviously that gives a hint as to what this is intended for. It's obviously, you can't accidentally switch off that critical equipment. So it comes with the key switch.
Yes.
That we're used to seeing on emergency light and switches. So you do that. But also, if you look at the end, Gary, it's got this little hook function here.
Yep.
Which, if I turn it over, pull in there, is to pull the fuse carrier out.
Fuse
in there.
That's a bit different, isn't it? We're normally used to seeing a little, maybe a slot down the side or a screw
to remove that fuse. Yeah, price that out with a screwdriver, yeah, or a screw to remove it. So obviously that makes it completely tamper-proof. The last thing you'd want somebody doing on one of those systems is just, yeah, levering the fuse holder out,
yeah,
you know, to stop the fire alarm by letting the batteries wear down.
Yeah, that's not a top tip, by the way, is it? In order to stop it ringing. Okay, so that's good. So that was obviously the easy one. But when I'm thinking Hamilton, I'm probably thinking decorative sockets for the domestic market. I'm perhaps not thinking metal clad.
No, and we've looked at Hamilton's full range of domestic sockets, all those finishers, yeah, the dimmer switches, the extensive range of USB chargers. But you think now, Gary, what's happening into the office? You know, what do offices look like now?
They're probably looking something like this, aren't they? We've got bare brick, where we've got maybe surface mounted conduits and socket outlets and switches, etc.
Yeah, and that trend has followed through into a lot of people's homes.
Yes.
Where, you know, yeah, the place that used to be a factory could now be somebody's home, and people like the exposed metal conduit, and hence the metal clad range from Hamilton. Still can use these in garages, workshops, factories, where they were, yeah, possibly
they're intended for.
Yeah,
absolutely. So let's go maybe next. Shall we have a look at the grid switches?
Yes, the grid switch, yeah.
I've got a vast range of grid switches, but it's actually how, again, you mount the actual frame or yoke onto the box itself. So I've done this. So what we generally do, don't we? We take the frame, we screw it into the box, and if you screw it all the way in, you often find that depth is too deep. So I've screwed this one all the way in, I put my front cover on, and you'll see what I've got now as an issue is that they're in too far.
A recessed switch.
Yeah, so that's obviously not acceptable. So what you end up doing is trying to guess, don't you, how far to back these screws back in order that now the switches meet the front
plate. So the face plate fixes them in place.
Absolutely. Yeah. So, and then it's the four screws on the front that's going to actually keep that frame in place. Well, Hamilton have thought about this. They come with some handy little spacers that simply clip onto the side of the yoke or grid mounting frame, whatever you want to call it. And when you fix those two on, now you can screw the frame tightly back into the box because you'll have a perfect depth now. So I'll just screw this one on for you. So once it's on, there we go, the perfect depth in order that we can have those frames. So four of those come with them. Top tip from eFIXX, don't lose them.
No, because they come in the box. Yeah, so they're in the box itself.
Yes.
So if you're first fixing this and going to decide on those switches later.
Yeah, just put them to one side, I would suggest.
Yeah, don't lose them. But yeah, that's a great little feature.
It's those subtle little things throughout the range that are really good. Now, when we're looking in that box, we noticed something else, didn't we, Gordon, that we thought was really good, because we'd had a painful experience earlier on in the week, haven't we?
Yeah, you wouldn't think tiny details, but some manufacturers put the earth tab on the opposite side so it interferes with the double entry of those two conduit knockouts there and stops in some instances getting the gland in place properly.
Yeah, we found that, so didn't we?
Yeah, loads of clearance room there, but again, tiny little feature, but worth mentioning.
Absolutely, yeah. Now, another thing on those grid switches, okay, is obviously getting them in and out of the frame itself. Now, often you have to sort of take a screwdriver, don't you, and sort of lever them in and out. No, not with the Hamilton range, Gordon. So here we go. I'll take the green neon one out. Little tab at the bottom there. Just lift it up, pop it out, and just lever it back in, and just gently press it, and it's back in.
Well, that's easy.
Yeah. It is easy. Yeah,
I'll have a try of that actually. I found this nice little cord outlet.
Yeah, flex outlet there. Just pop it in.
Just pushes in. Yeah.
Yeah, that's.
Want to get it out again?
Yeah. Yeah. No effort at all, is there?
No, really simple. And this, the grid range comes in everything from one way all the way up to, all right, to the eight-way version we've built up there.
And with the usual things, switches, double pole switches, fuse connection units, we've got neons, we've got red, amber, green, etc. And we've
got... Yeah, we've got everything, yeah, and no end of combinations. But it also includes another module, should we suggest, we've featured a lot recently.
Would that be the Euro module?
That's the Euro module.
We love a Euro module, don't we?
So we've got a Euro module frame here. Obviously, if it's going into residential or office spaces, data outlets are going to be important. USB charging, you know, the range comes with some USB chargers, but Hamilton have a standout product we looked at in a different video that delivers up to 45 watts of USB charging. Yeah. In a Euro module.
And having it in this range, it gives you the versatility, doesn't it, to have a, you know, USB and a data point next to each other, maybe even a single socket, etc., because that Euro module range also comes in a vaster range of accessories that go in, don't they, Gordon?
Yeah, so it seems like Hamilton have got the whole metal-clad range covered as well.
They have. As always, we're interested in your feedback. Are you currently fitting metal-clad accessories? Have you fitted the ones from Hamilton? Are you thinking about fitting them in the future? Is there anything else you'd like to see on the channel? As always, leave those comments below and we'll try and get back to as many as we can.